Takes care of the hold gates. Now we've a clear path to the villa. Let me make this very clear, though. If you've any thoughts of storming the place head-on, be rid of them now. I'll say I've taken you prisoner. That will buy us entry. Once we're inside, the battle's all but won. I even know where the king is likely held. Complaints?
No. I thank you for your assistance. I have my doubts, but I see no alternative.
Once we find the king, we'll hop aboard their ship and escape by air! How very dramatic!
Lady Adia, where have you been? We've lost contact with Master Crow. Wait. That woman! The Vestal of Wind!
Yes, and my prisoner besides. Now, if you'll open the gate, I'll bring her to the captain.
But what of Crow?
I'm afraid he fell before the wicked Vestal's cruel magic. But it was his sacrifice that allowed for her capture.
I see. Well, I am glad Milady is safe. I should expect no less from the Grand Marshal's daughter. I'll have the gate open straight away. Just a moment.
Hmm. Now, now. No need to glare. There, see? Inside without a hitch, thanks to my brilliant plan.
We need to find the king.
Hey, it's the traitor! Grab her!
News travels fast.
Some brilliant plan. What do we do now?
Murder. We beat them down.
Weathered the immediate storm. I'm afraid our little ruse is over, though.
Yes, well, at least we're inside, right?
Yes, right in the middle of the enemy stronghold. We've nowhere to run.
You can't think this was my intention. I swear by my honor, this is no trap. That's the very sort of craven act I can't abide.
Let's go.
Right.
Tis? Come to save us the trouble of finding you, Vestal? How very courteous. And just what are you doing here, Adia?
I'll go along with the Sky Knight's methods no longer.
You've no say in the matter. Defying orders is treason, girl!
Enough! You have us! Let the king go!
First, the Vestal comes to me. Alone!
You mustn't! I'll not keep my head at the cost of an innocent girl's.
You'll not keep your head at all if you keep running your mouth. Are you so eager to join the captain of your guard?
Heinkel, you were among the highest regarded warriors in the duchy. A paragon of chivalry. And the Sky Knights beneath you? I grew up on the tales of their brave and righteous deeds. But what I saw was a band of craven thugs. You defile the title of knight!
Greened fool. All hands, seize these four. Kill the men if you must.
Thank you.
such valor. You're quite the little heroes. And here I so hope to resolve this peacefully and let the good king go.
What?
Wilhelm! This is your answer? And still you'd call yourself a knight? As daughter to a true knight, I know their pride is staked upon fair and honorable combat. Release your hostage! Then stand and face us! No more running coward!
You invoke your father after betraying him?
He's headed for the airship!
That makes no sense. Why should he flee? His aim is the Vestal, not the king.
He's baiting us?
Still, we have to give chase. We'll lose him and the ship.
Well, I'm game to brave a trap.
I'm following you.
Agnes, let's go!
Right.
Ah, good. You came. You're a bold lot, if not a smart one. This ship is a prison you entered willingly. Nowhere to run now, save down. Quickly! Really, I must thank you for taking the bait so eagerly. It's earned you a lavish cruise through the clouds, Vestal. And for your friends, a career as ballast.
You're a prisoner here, same as us! No more tricks, Heinkel!
A knight without chivalry is a common bully. I'll see you stripped of that title here and now.
You wouldn't test your elders, girl. I thought to bring you home in chains, but no. All but the Vestal will end here as dew upon my blade. You'll die with the rest, traitor.
I saved this for you. We are. I'm a crack pilot, apparently.
Now find something to hold on to!
The kingdom of Caldisla owes you all a vast debt. I thank you from my heart of hearts. You, more than anyone, tis. A nightmare was visited upon you and your home, and still you rose up to defend ours. I'm certain your feats have earned Owen a peaceful rest. If you are willing, I would gladly see you take up his sword. Will you continue to keep this land safe, son?
You honor me, Your Highness, but I cannot accept. I've promised Agnes that I'll join her on her journey.
Caldisla shall be poorer for losing you. Know that you will ever have a home here. The Eternian airship is yours to use as you will. Take it with my blessing. There's not a man in the kingdom able to pilot it anyway. I leave the matter of that horrible chasm to you. I have faith you'll see it unmade. May the crystals keep you in your journey.
seems I've found a reason to come along. Now, my ladies, all you need do is simply speak the word, and I shall whisk you off to the very ends of existence.
And you're really sure that wasn't just a fluke before?
Rest assured, my dear. I never fail to properly escort a lady.
Agnes, will you tell us why they were chasing you?
The Sky Knights are a branch of the Eternian forces. The Duchy of Eternia has put forth an agenda of anti-crystallism.
Anti-crystallism?
A new way of thinking, based upon the idea of a society no longer dependent upon the crystals. It brands the Crystal Orthodoxy as a heretic faith, and the Vestals its minions. It was the philosophy I was raised upon. When the Chasm appeared, every one of the Eternian forces was given the order to capture the Vestals. They said the Vestals and the crystals they tend were the sinkhole's cause.
That's not possible! Agnes has been fighting this whole time to fix what happened to Narende.
I know. I'm sorry.
You've nothing to apologize for.
All of this paints the Duchy in a suspicious light, don't you think? Perhaps they know more of the Chasm's true cause than they let on.
I cannot imagine we've seen the last of them. If any of you wish to go, do it now. I'll not blame you.
I'm staying with you. I just told the King as much.
I'm in as well. I need to see for myself whether my people are right or wrong.
And playing escort is my job. I'll not cede it to anyone.
If none of you will listen to reason...
This is so exciting, Agnes! You're finally headed back to the Wind Crystal side!
Yes, to Anshine, the land of sand and time, and to the Temple of Wind.
Anshine? The land of sand and time? What's it like there?
Like an oasis in a vast desert beyond the sea. We make southeast of here. Still no wind.
Are these desert places normally supposed to be windy?
When they're the site of the wind crystal they are, this stillness shouldn't be possible.
The wind carried all manner of blessings to this land in days past. It was the kingdom's lifeblood.
I see. All the more reason to hurry then. Which way to the temple?
From here we need only head... we ought to make for... Which way is it?
Ignore anything she says. Anya's Reese is getting lost to an art form.
I'm impressed you made it to Caldisla.
Just a moment. My journal details much of Ansheim's topography. A clockwork metropolis nestled in Harina's sandy bosom. Here, time, above all, is sacred. A massive timepiece crowns the kingdom, fueled as all of Ansheim by the ceaseless currents originating from the Temple of Wind to the south.
Quite thorough, isn't it? Sounds as if you've been here before. Perhaps that book of yours is a travel diary?
I do seem possessed of a certain wanderlust. The normal sort as well. Ooh, perhaps I'll find a train of ex-lovers here among the sands.
Let's be off. We make south.
All present, Lord Marshal. Save the usual tomb, at least.
No matter. Let's begin.
I trust word has reached you from Caldisla. The Knights of the Eternian Sky have fallen to the Vestal.
I'd not thought the girl so bloodthirsty as all that.
It appears she surrounded herself with capable guards. What's more, it pains me to say it, but Idea's whereabouts have been lost amid the chaos.
That is no concern of yours. Do not confuse personal matters with your assigned task, Alternus.
My apologies, Lord Marshal.
Not only did the Sky Knights fail, they've given the Vestal wings. Why they didn't simply kill the child, I'll never know.
Keen, insightful as ever, Victoria. Yes, I fear we've need of the Vestal alive.
Have we, Victor? No matter then. If she fled by air, it's a simple matter to track her. She makes for Ansheim by necessity.
And to the Temple of Wind. Ansheim does face upon the Florshine Sea.
Of course. Most of the world's seas have gone putrid, but the inner sea remains navigable. That would offer the airship a berth. But what does she aim to do there? Why return to the crystal now? It smells of some sinister plot.
Ansheim is the province of the Camar and Profiteur merchantry. What say you, Lord Marshal?
We haven't the leisure of chasing the Vestal across the globe and back. We need her in custody now. Tell the merchantry to employ any means they must.